right, guys, today we're gonna be talking about how to create a blue ocean strategy, okay? This, what I'm gonna be showing you today, is from a book called Just Like That, Blue Ocean Strategy. You guys definitely should check it out, look it up on Amazon or whatever you wanna buy, Blue Ocean Strategy, okay? So I'm gonna explain you how to create a quadrant that is gonna help you, your business, okay, in creating a strategy, all right, so you could prosper and move and grow and expand on your business, okay? So first, let me explain the term blue ocean. On the book it says there's a blue ocean and there's a red ocean. There's two types of ocean, okay? But there's a difference, of course, right? But the red ocean is red because there's so much competition, you know, like companies competing against each other and fighting, and there's blood on the water, man. There's spilling blood on the water. That's why the ocean is red. But a blue ocean is something new, something different, new market. Is so basically, you gotta see how to move from a red ocean where you know there's not gonna be there's gonna be a lot of fighting, man, a lot of fighting and a lot of blood. You gotta get out of there and create, how to create a blue ocean. That's what we're gonna be talking about today, okay? So this is a quadrant. There's four things you gotta think about. And over here, so you can understand, I'm gonna be talking about Cirque du Soleil. Great show, you know, they do in Vegas, Orlando, whatever, around the world. So on the book it says, they're using Cirque du Soleil as an example, and I just thought it was such an amazing example that I wanna also share it with you. So for example, Cirque du Soleil eliminated star performers, okay? So think about it, on the circus, they had, you know, whatever, Johnny Rocket Fire, you know, somebody who's like super popular that everybody wanna see because he jumps and he do like aerobatics and stuff, and you know, the guy is popular, is famous, that people wanna go because they wanna see Johnny, right? It's a star. So Cirque du Soleil eliminated star performers, right? So basically, they have a character, you know, that it could be played by whoever. There's nobody that is a star here. You know, that what people comes to see is the character, and the character could be anybody. You could just get this guy out, put another one. This the character, okay? So let's say somebody's playing Aladdin, right? Aladdin could be anybody. You know, you take this guy out, put another one, because the people is not following the star. They have characters, okay? But why they did this? You know how much money they save by taking the star performers out and not dealing with that? Because remember, a star performer will have a high cost in terms of how much they wanted to get paid to be on the circus, to be on that circus playing that night, you know, and doing whatever his thing. So they were, you know, saving a lot of money just by not having a star and just having characters, okay? Animal shows. A lot of people are getting onto some type of, you know, awareness now because of animals. People is concerned how animals are treated. You know, even one of the theme parks got into some type of you know, a dilemma because people were concerned how they would treat the animals and you know, it's just a delicate topic right now. Animals, how, you know, and on the shows you see, like, you know, that they're on the circuits, right? You know, with the whip, you know, and how they train the animals and all that. So it was a little bit a topic that it was concerning a lot of people. So they decided to eliminate animal shows on Cirque du Soleil. We're not gonna have animals here. And just by doing that, they save a lot of money as well. Because animals, they you know, they needed to have insurance. They needed to feed them. They needed to transport them from show, you know, from circus to circus to circus. They, you know, they needed a place to sleep. animals. Okay, so it was expensive to keep these animals. So they reduced it. There was a lot of dilemma on that topic as well. So why not just remove it? And now we also save a lot of money. So they eliminated star performers and they eliminated animal shows. Now, what you need to reduce, okay? The first step, you eliminate. Now, what you need to reduce on your business? So Cirque du Soleil, they reduce the fun and humor. So when you go to a circus, okay, a normal circus, it's silly. You know, it's more like for the kids. You know, you got the clown, like playing with the little boy, with the hair and the big shoes and all that. You know, so they eliminated that because they were aiming not just to look for the kids as the audience. They wanted also adults as well, right? So they eliminated, reduce it, the fun and the humor, because they wanted not just the kids, they wanted the whole family. They wanted adults as well, you know? So now, the third step on the quadrant is to raise. What can we raise as a business, okay? So what they raised was the unique venue. So what do that mean? It's created that type of place that you go and it's just magical, just the way it's decorated, you know, just everything you see, the smells and you know, like the scents and the place itself, the seats, you know, like for example, on a normal circus, it was uncomfortable. You know, you had the bench, you know, you're over there, like hard bench, maybe you don't even got nobody to put your back, you know, like no back, you know, like just a bench, uncomfortable. Over here, they created an experience. Now you're comfortable, you're sitting down, you're enjoying this whole decoration, how everything is so beautiful and unique, okay? So they raised that, all right? And now the fourth step on the strategy quadrant is you need to create something that nobody, you know, something different that no other business, no other company has. So what they did is they created a theme. So when you go to Cirque du Soleil, they have a story, a theme. So it could be, one show could be called The Vengeance of Rio, you know, and the other ones could be the romance of this and that. So they have different themes. They have a story. They have a good guy, a bad guy. They have the lady and the man with the romance. And they have, it's a storyline, right? They have a theme, which circus don't, you know? They have a theme, okay? A whole story, and they have different themes. And also, they created artistic music and dance, okay? Something the circus didn't have. So now they started to create something completely different. It got some elements from a circus, but they added elements from live theater. So what happened, now Cirque du Soleil is not a circus. They're different. And they're not live theater, they're different. So what happened? They came out from the red ocean and now created a blue ocean where either the circus or the live theater, they're completely irrelevant. You know, they created a whole blue ocean strategy, okay? Hey, so think about it. Take this, do this quadrant. You entrepreneur that are watching me, sales guy, you know, whatever you are right now, whatever you wanna, a strategy that you want to create, business owner, executive, implement it, okay? What you're gonna eliminate, what you're gonna reduce, what you're gonna raise, what you're gonna create, okay? And check the book out. I highly recommend the Blue Ocean Strategy. Look it up on your favorite bookstore. Hey man, hope this helps. Blessings.